designated as the deadliest terrorist organization in the world in January 2008 by the FBI. Even in a situation where they did not pose a direct threat to the USA, the organizations like Al-Qaeda, which did pose direct threat to the USA, were ranked lower than the LTT by the Americans. After I took office as president in 2005, I appointed the best person I knew for the job to the position of Defense Secretary, and on his recommendations, appointed other suitable officers and put in place the military machine that won the war. Today, that Defense Secretary Gotabaya Rajapaksa is your president and commander-in-chief, elected by the people with an overwhelming mandate. We once again assume leadership of this nation at a time when our national sovereignty and national security is under threat. This year, we had the Easter Sunday bombings, which was the deadliest terrorist attack on civilian targets to take place anywhere in Asia. Even though this is a small country, the challenges that we have had to face are not small at all. If we don't get on top of the situation, all neighboring countries, including India, the Maldives, Bangladesh, and even countries further off, like Myanmar and Thailand and Malaysia, will be under threat. So this new terrorist threat will have to be contained by whatever means necessary. Countries in our immediate neighborhood and beyond are well aware of the danger, and we can expect their fullest cooperation in this regard. We all know that there are various agendas at the international level operational with regard to our armed forces. There are instances where certain foreign parties objected to promotions made within our armed forces. No sovereign country will allow such foreign interference in the internal affairs of its armed forces. The political authorities will provide the armed forces of Sri Lanka with the leadership to achieve the objective of ensuring the national security of a sovereign Sri Lanka. That is our pledge to the armed forces and the people of Sri Lanka.